So we had done the plane whose normal was given. That means we had done the normal form, right? Whose normal was given and whose distance from the origin, that means the perpendicular distance, the was given, right? And I had told you two very technical things about that, because what was the way in which the equation was represented? First, normal form is what? R dot n cap is equal to d, fine? And I had told you, if and only if this is n cap, then only this will be the distance, and this should be positive, then this will be n cap, correct? Now we come to the second form of equation, where what was given? The normal to the plane is given, the normal to the plane is given, and a fixed point through which the plane passes is given. We understand? So let me draw the diagram, and again we will be faced with the limitation that we are drawing a 3D on a 2D, so you will not be able to visualize it. So we will have to see it in a real life scenario. Okay, so maybe if this is the plane, fine, this is the plane, okay, and we are given the normal. Now again I am telling you, the normal may be either any vector n, or it could be the unit vector n, okay? So I assume that this time it is, and from here it goes away. So this is your normal. So maybe you are given this vector n. This is my origin, this is my x-axis, y-axis, z-axis, x-axis, y-axis, z-axis, okay? This is your normal, and you are given a point through which it passes, okay? So maybe the point is say this is a fixed point. It lies on the plane, okay? This lies on the plane. So let the position vector of this be A, okay? And I have any other position vector on this, a general position vector, that is representing the point x, y, z. So R is equal to x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap is some general point, say this, okay? So this is R, this point is x, y, z. Now you see what happens. This is my plane, okay, so suppose this is my plane, this is my origin, this is my plane. I'm just showing you like this, maybe it is something like, it could be like this also. So there is a perpendicular vector, so it is coming and it pierces the plane and goes away, right, that direction. This is the normal vector, okay, from the origin. Now what happens? There is this from the origin only, there is this. So from the origin there is this green pen which is a normal vector, okay? So this is, just hold this book. So this is your normal vector. This is the origin, right? I have got some other vector which is like this. It is again from the origin. Do you see that, all of you? This is again from the origin itself. So it goes like that. Okay? So I have two vectors. Okay? I have two vectors. So this is A vector. I have another vector. Hold on. I have another vector. See, this is A vector. This is N vector. I have another vector that is R vector. Now, this blue pen is R vector. This red pen is A vector. Now, R minus A lies on the plane. Correct? Do we get that? So, I will say that this vector R minus A lies on the plane. Okay? It lies on the plane. And since the perpendicular vector is the perpendicular vector is perpendicular to the plane, so it is perpendicular to all the vectors lying on the plane. Correct? So R minus A lies on the plane and N is perpendicular to the plane, hence it is also perpendicular to the vector R minus A. So what happens? R minus A dot N is equal to 0. Is it not? So therefore R minus A dotted with N is equal to 0. Now this can be expressed as R dot N minus A dot N is equal to 0. So R dot N is equal to A dot N. Now, if you want to express it as the normal form, what do? You divide both the sides by, but that I will do later. Let me first convert it into the Cartesian form, right? So this is your vector. Okay, or more precisely, this is your vector. This is how you should remember it. This or this, whatever, leave it. You remember it like this. Right. Okay. Now, what is my R? Till now, we know what these vectors are. Xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap. What is A? A is equal to x1 I cap plus y1 j cap plus z1 k cap. What is N? N is A I cap plus B j cap plus C k cap. This is in a sense what? What is it? This represents the ABC, represents the direction ratios. Should keep on repeating that, never lose sight of that. I, j, k, the coefficients of I, j, k will always represent direction ratios. In this case, they name it like this, because now you understand, they should have written it as small a, small b, small c. Okay? But they write it like this. Now, what is R minus A dot N? R minus A dot N is equal to 0, 0 vector. Now, what does that tell you? So, it gives you R minus A will be what? X minus X1 I cap, Y minus Y1 J cap, plus Z minus Z1 K cap. Is it not? This is dotted with A I cap plus B J cap plus C K cap is equal to 0. Now what does that give you? So that gives you a into x minus x1 plus b into y minus y1 plus c into z minus z1 is equal to 0. So that is the Cartesian form of the equation. Okay. So this is the vector form. This is the Cartesian form. Okay. Fine. Now what? What next? I'd like you to see this equation as this as well. See, I have r minus a dot n is equal to 0. That gives me r dot n is equal to a dot n. Now if I divide both sides by mod n, I get this becomes n cap. So it becomes r dot n cap is equal to a dot n cap. Okay. Now if you compare it with whatever you have already studied, our normal form. Normal form said what? This. So this tells you what? That a dot n cap is the distance of this plane from the origin. So if you compare it with normal form, okay, so comparing it with one, we see that a dot n cap is equal to d, that is the distance of the plane from the origin. Now I'd like to give you another insight into this. This is your n vector. This is your n vector that goes through, okay? So it is kind of like this. So my palm is a plane, so it's something like this. Now my a vector is like this, okay? Now if you see it clearly, maybe it is something like this, it could also be like this. If you see, what is my distance? My distance is actually from here till there. Now is it not the projection of A, this pen, A onto the red one, that is the N, is not my distance D equal to the projection of vector A, the position vector of this fixed point, onto the normal vector? Is it not? This will be the projection, okay? Projection is the perpendicular from there, from wherever is the tip of the, wherever is the tip of this vector, from where you draw a perpendicular, wherever it cuts the other vector, that is the projection. That's how the projection has been taught to us. Okay, that is how we have defined projection. Now what happens? So alternate, I'm just trying to give you an insight that distance d from the origin is actually the projection of A on N, and which is therefore d is equal to a dot n cap. What is the projection of a on b? A dot b cap. What is the projection of b on c? b dot c cap. जिसके ऊपर projection होता है वो cap हो जाता है और उसके साथ आप dot कर देते हो, that's all. Okay. If you understand it this way, then it gives you so many alternate insights. What have we done? We have converted this like a normal form, or we did not even do this. We straight away used our this formula. इसलिए what I am saying is, you should understand those small things that have been taught to you. What is projection? What is the vector joining two points? What is dot product of two perpendicular vectors? What is the cross product? The more you understand those, the more you understand this. Because ultimately you'll see, what are we on the lookout for? We try to find out a vector and vector in something and dot it with a perpendicular vector to get zero. That's all that we are doing. Okay. So let us do some questions based on that.